Hey everyone, happy Wednesday. So you know today is Worship Wednesday. So today we're just going to worship, praise the Lord Jesus, giving him all honor and praise. We should praise and worship Jesus every single day if we can. But you know, if not, that's fine. But on the majority, we should, because he's worthy to our praise. When you praise the Lord, it brings faith, it brings that security and gives you hope, like, oh, I know who my God is. So we're just going to praise the Lord, and just the Holy Spirit is welcome here. And just when you hear this music, don't get distracted. Just listen to the words. The words are important. And I just pray that when we worship, that the Lord on heaven and earth would loose a breakthrough in all areas of our life where it's needed. Healing, restoration, deliverance, and all those things. And just joy and a peace that passes all understanding. In Jesus' name, amen. And the first song I'm going to play, and you may know it already, even though this is the second video of worship, but I am a fan of Cece Winans, and I did go and see her when she was just here, and I wish that she can come back. But anyways, the first song I am going to play is by my favorite Cece Winans, and it's called I Have a Savior. You guys, listen and enjoy. It's called I Have a Savior. Let's remember that we have a Savior who can do anything.
I have a Savior, a friend forever, the lover of my soul. Through every trial, he won't forsake me. I'll never be
always mean.
All I want to sing is his name. All my heart belongs to Jesus, and by his grace and mercy I'm saved.
You have to remember, it's his grace and mercy why we're saved. It's not us, it's him. He came to us.
There are no riches that could persuade me or steal away my soul. I have been ransomed now and forever, my Savior, my reward. All I ever need is Jesus.
Jesus is our reward, our everlasting reward, you guys. Always remember that. We should see him as the most beautiful, amazing reward that we have ever gotten.
You're my future, you're my hope. You're the anchor for my soul. And now you're the anchor for my soul. Man!
prayer, just in that song, you are now a child of a God. Amen. So the next song that I am going to play is, I'm going to play Believe For It by Cece Winans. And listen to the words, please, because this music and just all godly music, it just strengthens your faith. It reminds you who our God is and what he's done, what he's capable to do, and not to never limit him ever. Okay. Believe For It by Cece Winans.
This mountain can be moved. They say these chains will never break, but they don't know you like we do. There is power in your name. We've heard that there is no way.
Everything that you're asking God, that you're believe for it right now.
We know that hope is never lost. Oh, for there is still an empty grave. God, we believe no matter what. There is power in your name. So much power.
Believing for this nation that souls will be won in Jesus' name.
You have to find.
all of this with his face. Yes, God, we do believe for it. In everything that we were praying for, in everything you have been praying for, just believe. And every time I hear that song, I think about everything that I'm praying for, and I think about the souls, because at times it may look like it's impossible for people to come to Christ, a family member, a loved one, a friend, a lover, or sometimes just looking at people's life and you just care about them and you just want what's best for them. It can be hard at times, and it's just like Jesus can do it. And with that being said, I do
Jen McDonald will protect reproductive rights and make healthcare more.
End with the prayer. because I know that those songs were long, but yes, worth it. So I do want to end in a godly prayer, and just want you guys to know to believe that God can do it and that He will do it, and not to worry and not to ever think that He can't do it. And remember the first song we sang, we have a Savior who can do the impossible. Jesus is our reward. He's not in the tomb anymore. He has arisen. So we have a hope. We have a promise that He can give us, Father God. And just believe and Jesus loves you. And I'm just gonna, wherever how the Holy Spirit lead me to pray, I'm just going to pray. But I just put on some background instrumental. Father God, I just ask you right now, we come to you today, Father God, to just first lift your name high. Thank you, Father God, for each and everything you have done for us, Father God. We just thank you for the highs and the lows, Father God. We thank you for giving us chances that we didn't deserve, Father God, but it was your grace and mercy that gave us that chance, Father God. I ask you, Father God, to please just loose on heaven and earth your wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and revelation of Jesus Christ, of who you are and what you have done on the cross, Father God, and what does that mean, that what we can receive and have, Father God, through that. I ask you, Father God, to just strengthen us, Father God. Strengthen us as we go through trials and tribulations, Father God. Strengthen us as we go through for righteous sake, Father God, here, Father God, in America and in other countries, Father God, where they get persecution really bad and worse, Father God. But I ask you, Father God, as us, as the children of God, around the world, and myself, Father God, who I'm praying for, as we go through persecution, Father God, have us not to lose hope, Father God. Have us to know that everything that we go through is temporal, Father God, and the reward that you have for us, Father God, is greater than what we go through, Father God. Have us to know that it won't be long, Father God, until we see your face, Father God. And also, Father God, just have us to know at the end of the day, to die is to gain, Father God, because to be in your presence is the best thing to be, Father God. But still, we lose on heaven and earth long life, Father God, life more and abundantly, and we just mine on heaven and earth the spirit of death, sickness, disease, infirmity, plagues, calamities, premature death, accidents, criminal activities, Father God. And Father God, everyone that is looking for an answer, Father God, from you with whatever it is, Father God, I ask you to meet their need and to answer them, Father God, and to bring them confirmation and clarity in the things and situations that you need them to know and want them to do, Father God. I just ask you, Father God, to just strengthen us all, Father God. Bring a revival around this world to save souls, Father God. And I just ask you to convict the unbelievers' hearts, Father God, to get saved, to convict the unbelievers' hearts to come back to you, Father God, and to just convict the heart of the believers, Father God, when things we are doing wrong, but bring us back to the straight and narrow path to everlasting life, Father God, and just help us all to just trust you, knowing that you died on the cross for our victory in any and each area we may need, Father God. Even if it may seem little to others, or even at our times little to us, have us not to limit you and pray and ask you, Father God, what we need or want, Father God. Have us not to put limits on you because we think it's stupid, because we think it's dumb, or just for whatever reasons, Father God. Have us not to see you the way how we see you, Father God, but how you should be seen, Father God. Remove our flesh and our dark veils, Father God, and just loose on heaven and earth spiritual eyes, Father God. Help us not to yield or quench the Holy Spirit, Father God. and have us to be led by the Holy Spirit and to hear and listen and be obedient to the Holy Spirit, Father God. Because the more we're obedient, the more that we can hear your voice, the more that we can gain that clarity, the more that we can know what you want us to, what needs to be done, Father God. I just ask you to help us to focus on doing our Father's business, Father God, which is your purpose, and in any way, shape, and form, Father God. But whatever we do, your purpose to help us to win souls, Father God, to care and love souls, Father God, that is not about us, but it's about Jesus, Father God. I ask you to strengthen us and just again pray that we be about our Father's business. And I believe that this is already done by the blood of Jesus that shed it on Calvary more than 2,000 years ago. Just give us the faith, the patience, perseverance, and endurance, Father God, to believe until we see our answered prayers, Father God, in the physical. And I thank you, Father God, for already doing it. And I know that it is already done by the blood of Jesus shed on Calvary more than 2,000 years ago. And I thank you, Daddy Jesus, for already doing it. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. And alrighty, you guys, that was prayer and worship for today. Remember that Jesus loves you. I love you. And never feel bad about the things that you battle with. Always remember that Jesus wants to help. He wants to give you that clarity. He wants to give you that deliverance, that healing. It's never that he don't want to. But remember, in this season of confusion, doubt, unbelief, to just ask, even ask him what you want him to, what is he trying to get your attention with for, if that made sense what I said. But just ask just what he wants you to see. But remember to never stop asking until your prayer is answered. I love you guys, but Jesus love you more. Be blessed.